Hello, welcome to our DigitalU Connecting Washington Libraries webinar. Today's topic is Great Apps for Mobile Reference and Outreach. And our presenter is Richard Leaf. He's a Team Services Librarian. And this presentation was one of the very popular ALA presentations in the recent past, and I read about it and thought it would be perfect for this series. And so I contacted Richard and his co-presenter, Mo, and Richard agreed to do this presentation. Mo's not able to be here today, but we're fortunate to have Richard. And so for this software, if you have questions, feel free to type in chat or raise your hand. Raising hand button. It looks like a little hand. You just click on that, and then we can call on you. Or you can type in chat and then hit enter. If you have comments, feel free to chat away. We'll be monitoring the chat. We do have a limited number of talkers. When we call on you to talk, go ahead and click the talk button one time, and your microphone should be activated. And then when you're done clicking, when you're done talking, go ahead and click it off. And that way, we will not have interference. So, and if you have trouble with the audio, there's an audio setup wizard. You just click right there and follow the instructions. Also, you can give a shout out. We have two technical helpers today, Jeremy Stroud and Joe Oliver, and they are here to help you out. So if you are having technical issues, go ahead and type in chat a help me message, and they will work with you to get you up and running. And so now it's my pleasure to turn this over to Richard to talk about some great apps. Thank you, Richard, for agreeing to come and talk to us today.
Thank you, Jennifer. Just want to say how honored I am to be here to talk about great apps for mobile reference and outreach. And just to let you know that I'm using a DSL connection, so if I lose connections or having a lot of background noise, I apologize for that because I'm doing this at home. And then, yeah, so it's going to be fun today, and I'm going to show you or talk to you about many apps that you can use for your libraries or when you're doing for your outreach. So, and I encourage you to text or if you had or chat, type in any apps that you find or interesting, or if you like what I'm saying, just give me a shout out, okay? And it's going to be really quick. I'm going to give you a lot of statistics on the apps. And so here's my contact information. I'm a team services librarian. I'm currently working for the San Francisco Public Library. And I give talks at different conferences, internet librarians, ALA, and CLA, California Library Associations, and so forth. So if you want to follow me, you can go to Twitter's. And also, if you want, email me. So I will give you everything at the end, and I'll probably, if you want more apps, then I'll give you a handout as well. So this session is meant to be fun and interactive, so feel free to jump right in, text, and then it's going to be a lot of information. I'm going to talk about apps for reference, outreach, and different tools that as a librarian or a library professional or paraprofessional you can use to help your patrons or library users. So today what I have for you is I'm going to talk a little bit about current trends and on mobile technologies and apps and how they offer libraries and librarians new opportunities. And I'm going to talk a little bit about app selections, what is a good apps, and I'm going to feature, talk about 40 mobile apps for reference, and then at the end I'll answer any question you have. So current trends. According to the Pew Internet studies in May 2003, the ownership of mobile device has gone up. 56% of the population owns a smartphone, 34% owns a tablet, and then 91% of the population survey owns a cell phone. Approximately, these are the statistics for different mobile platforms. Android, 28%, iPhone, 25%, and BlackBerry, 4%. So this gives you an overview of how prevalence or how widely used smartphones are. So this is the projections, another study done, and they were projecting approximately there will be 222 million cell phone users projected in, by 2017. And currently they're estimating that by the end of this year there will be 181.4 million. Approximately 57.3% of the population. And last year was 155.1 million. So this gives you a sense of, this slide gives you a sense of the mobile platforms or sales. According to the Gartner study in this year, sales is expected to be reach 197 million units for mobile devices and tablets. And this number, the sales of tablets and mobile devices, is expected to surpass desktop. And by 2017, they projected that the sales is going to make up approximately 83% of the mobile device market. So pretty big. In terms of download of apps, approximately 13.4 billion apps download worldwide for 2012. And among all the apps download, healthcare apps make up a huge market, approximately $1.3 billion in 2012. So what are people doing? What are the top five activities when you're on a cell phone? First, they check weather. They do social networking, road navigation, get information about maps and so forth. And they also read online, and they play games. So these are a number of statistics. Just to give you how much we are connected with our mobile device or cell phone or smartphone, approximately 62% of the population survey reach out immediately after waking up. They reach out for their cell phone. About 79% of them reach out for their cell phone within 15 minutes of waking up. Now, I know that many of you are part of the statistics, and can I get a show of hands how many people reach out to their cell phone immediately after waking up? Yeah, I know. I'm guilty of that too. So, very interesting. Just to let you know that approximately 44% of American adults slept with their cell phone just because they don't want to miss a call. And about 67% of them checked their call or messages even if the phone is not ringing. And about 29% of them said or reported that they can't imagine living without a smartphone or cell phone. And so what are the opportunities for us as a librarians or paraprofessionals or for libraries? First, why should we care? We care because the smartphone and mobile technologies or platform offer quick access to information on the go. It allows us as a librarian to engage our patrons or library user and to let them know about the different kind of information out there they can have. And then also allow us to promote our interactions and talk to or work with our patrons to tell them and inform them there's a huge amount of resources out there via a mobile device. and also to foster learning and exploration. And just imagine we can integrate our existing library services at a point of service into these mobile platform. So I'm going to switch gear and talk about the selection criteria. And these are just my selection criteria. When I select app, I want something, an app to be free, educational, and useful. I want something, an app that contains a huge database of information, things that would make my search easy. I want something that has a good review. I want also an app that is properly supported. I don't want it to download and then later turn out it's not working. So now I'm going to talk about 40 apps for reference and outreach. And I just want to get a show of hand if you are excited about it, or give me a show of hand whether you're excited so far or you like this presentation so far, in addition to all the statistics. So these are the categories that I'm going to be talking about: online database app, cooking, recipe, traveling and local information, government, health and fitness, education, financial information, and so on. And I'm also going to talk about the kind of information that as a librarians we often use, like books and literature, dictionary, local events, and most importantly, tools that we can use. So the first one I want to feature is that it's called Access My Library. I don't know if anyone of you are familiar with that, but basically this app allows, if your library is subscribed to the Gale's database, you have access to all your resources with this app. So they have the three different versions of that. One is the public, school, and academic version. So there are three apps, so you have to download the corresponding app. So basically it allows you to access your library subscription Gale database. It allows you to search all your database within 10-mile radius of your location. And what I like about it is that you can get a free access to your library database. Your library patron will be able to do that without having to sign in to your library card. So this is a really cool app if you're thinking, if you're doing outreach or if you're promoting your library resources, the Gale's database, to your library user or patron. So when I do my outreach, I usually download or recommend people, patrons, to download this app. Within, they don't have to step foot in the library. They can just, within 10 miles of radius near a library, they can access all your electronic resources, Gale electronic resources. Another good app is All Recipe. A lot of time when I'm working at the reference desk, I often get questions about cooking recipe using certain ingredients and so forth. This is a really good app to recommend to patrons if they're thinking about doing some cooking at night, especially during the holiday seasons. You can search using this app, you can search by ingredient, cooking time, and also the type of dish. And you can create, once you select a recipe, you can create shopping lists from the recipe, and you can save it onto your cell phone. You can take the shopping list to a supermarket. And you can also scan by ingredients, barcode, and you can add it to your shopping list. And what I particularly like about this app is that you can search by ingredient or dietary restriction. A lot of times, let's say you have hyper pressure or hyper tensions or cholesterol or something, you can program it in and it'll give you, recommend some recipe that will fit your health condition. Another good app is for financial information is Bloomberg. These apps give you the financial news and market indexes, and it has the stock finder, which allows you to search for individual stock information, including highs, low, or 52-week summaries, and all the financial information that you'll need. What I particularly liked about this app is that it's very easy to use, and it gives you the latest stock information. A lot of time, patrons would come to a reference desk and ask you about, oh yeah, do you have Value Line or Morningstar? And what if that particular, you know, items are not available? You can recommend them using the Bloomberg app. Perhaps they can get similar information. The next app what I wanted to feature is it's called Quick Tax Reference. This will give you current tax rates for individuals and corporations. It also gives you standard deduction, exemptions, mileage rates, and capital gains and dividends. So it is almost like a one-stop place for quick reference, tax reference, especially during the end of the year or the beginning of the year when people come in to your library and ask for tax information. So it may not be, you have to really check to see if their information is reliable, because a lot of time this is just a quick general information that they put out. It's not, another word, is not state specific. So you have to check. And what I like about this app is very easy to navigate, it's very easy to use, the good clean interface, and so forth. This is a tool, it's called Cam Scanner. Basically, it turns your cell phone or mobile device into a fax machine and copier or scanner. Just think of it how useful it is when you're doing outreach, when you're, let's say, you're out in a bookmobile or out in a field or even away from your desk or a location where you don't have access to a fax machine or a copier or a scanner. This app will replace all those devices or those machines. It allows you to scan pages, save different in different size, and also give you a, you can, once you scan your page, you can put in a PDF format, save it as a PDF. You can send an email and share your scan. This is a wonderful tool if you're doing outreach, and also for those patrons or library who don't have maybe access to a fax, or if they want to send a resume to their potential employers, or if you're there are in your library just doing research, but they don't have enough money to make photocopies, and they can, you can recommend them using this app. This is a free app that they can use to photocopy your materials in the library. And what I like about it is that it basically replaces all the copy machines, fax machines, and so forth, the different services. So you got, you guys like it so far? Give me a shout out if you like the app so far. Good. Okay, the next app I want to feature is called the City Guide Catalog. This app gives you quick city guide tour, and it's mainly for travelers, and it includes restaurant, attractions, hotel, and guided tour. What I liked about this app, unlike compared to other apps, is that it works offline. It has also a GPS-based direction map, and so it is. This app sort of replaces your traditionals or a travel section. So in other words, if you're out in the field and you want to, somebody asks you a question about a particular location or travel location, a destination, you want to give them information, and this would be a great app to recommend, especially for people, older people who want to travel, you know, during the summertime. For me, I have recommended this app to so many people, and they just are thrilled to know that there's such an app available to get all the information they need. And what's so nice about this app is it gives you, it recommends you all the travel attractions, and with a one click of a button, you can, because it's GPS based, you can get the exact location or driving location to the destination or the attraction. It's really good. Another app that I use frequently at the reference desk is the Edmunds Call Review. A lot of time people come into the reference desk and they want to look at the Kelly's Blue Book, or if they want to buy a used car or they want to sell their car, they just want to get some information on, you know, a car and the car values. So this, I recommend this because a lot of time most of the Kelly's Blue Books are, you know, reference copy. They can't take it out. So a lot of time I recommend this app because they can take it at home and they can download this app and find new and used car information. And what I particularly like about this app is that you can search for a particular car or model by location. And so location meaning the location of the local dealer. And you can calculate monthly loan and lease payment. And also it has a true market value listing, so that will give your patrons or library user the exact information that they'll need. And what I like about it is that it has a loan calculator, and a lot of time people are, you know, thinking how much money they'll need to put in for their used or new car. So this is a really nice app, very easy to use, very clean interface, and is free. Another similar app is the Kelly Blue Book app. Allows you to do car research, and it gives you, what I like about it, it gives you a direct access to the car pricing. And a lot of time the patients come and they want to know the exact price or in comparison to different model. This will give you that, and it also gives you the review. And particularly, I like this app because it also calculates the car values, meaning that you can, there's a list of features or models you can check or uncheck, and it'll give you, or it will give you or estimate the value of your car. It also give you comparisons of different cars side by side. And what I like about it is one last feature is that it gives you, it allows you to make requests for quote from the dealer. So if you find a car that you like, you can request for a quote from your local dealer. And so these are wonderful, wonderful apps that a librarian, you know, must have in their at their disposal. Another app is a medical app. It's called First Aid. It's published by the American Red Cross. It gives you, this app gives you step-by-step first aid advice and on different scenarios. And they also give you the latest new training videos and animation. This is really good for students who come in, nursing students or teachers who want to learn about first aid response and in different scenarios, and as well as to want to watch some training videos like CPRs and so forth. And what's so nice about it is that this app works offline. Once you download this app on your mobile device or a phone, you can easily access the content without having a Wi-Fi connection. So this would be a great tool for moms and teachers who are taking their kids or taking their students out on a trip or a field trip, and if someone gets injured, they can easily use this app to access or get the information or the first aid advice that they need. And this app is really good because it is very, it gives you a lot of visual or videos. And it's sort of almost like we place your first aid or medical materials on the shelf. So another good app that I would recommend is the Merck PTE. Stands for Periodical Table of Elements. So this app gives you concise periodic table of elements, and they also give you different element data, classifications, groups, and subsets. And it's good for if you have for high school students and also elementary school students who are doing chemistry work. And then I like the layout of this particular app because it's very clean and it has good interface and then very short and concise get to the point information. So I would totally recommend this app for school teachers, high school teachers, and even parents or tutors. Another good app I want to recommend is the Merriam-Webster app. It's free. There is a paid version of that, but this is good enough for a layperson. So this is an authoritative, and we give you authoritative and reliable source for definitions. What I like about it is that this apps enable you, because it has a speaker function, it enables you to the person to speak. A lot of time people come to you or the reference desk if they don't know how to spell a word. And to begin with, that's what they want a dictionary for, be able to spell a word. This app allows you to speak into a speaker or microphone, and it'll automatically search for the word. And I like about it because it sort of replaced the almost like the desk dictionary. And it has a really good features that allow you to search by voice as well. And so just a reminder, if you know any similar apps that does the same thing, please use the chat features and type in the app. Perhaps we can share. That's one thing I want to do in this session is, in addition to giving you information or all those apps, I want you to also to share with your colleague any app, any useful app that you're currently using in the library or helping your patrons or a library user. So let's do that. Another good app that I want to recommend is called the Top Movie, a zoomable timeline of movie. Basically, this app gives you a timeline of all the top movie. It allows you to select or type in a period of a time period and explore in a topic. So basically, you type in, let's say, 1940s, and then it will give you a list of popular movie at that time. And once you get the movie, you can click on the link, tap on the movie, and it will give you more information about the cast, the summary, or the synopsis or the storyline of the movie, and so forth. This is a really good tool to you because a lot of time people come to you and ask for, yeah, I want to know, you know, like what's going on in back in 1950 or back in the early days. So I just want, you know, a lot of time they come to you and they say, give me some information. I heard about this movie and I want to know more about it. So you would recommend this app or use this app to search or look for information. And what I like about it is it has a comprehensive database for movie lovers and film students. And it's comparable to the movie guides, you know, all the movie review titles that we have on a show. So really good app. Another app that I use frequently for collection development is EasyBit. This app allows you to basically scan the ISBN of a book and then generate a list, create a list of books or titles, and then you can format it in a way that you want it in different styles. For example, MLA, APA, and Chicago style citations. And basically, you can use this app to build or manage your work, as well as to create booklets. And for example, if you're doing a book club or if you're making a book list, you can select, go to your shelf, select a list of books that you want to push. Scan the back of the ISBN at the book and then generate a list. And what you do is you, once you gather your list, you can really enter the email that you want to, maybe a group email that you want to push this particular the list of books that you want to send out. This is a really good tool if you're doing a book club or if you are currently making a recommendation for a reading. I use this app solely for collection management. When I go to a shelf, instead of carrying a scanner with me, or if books I want to read out or replace, then I would easily use my phone and scan in the back of the ISBN and gather all those title information so I can go back to my desk and upload or email to myself, and then I can do whatever I want. So this is a really good app for collection management as well as creating book lists and inventory. Free books. Is another app that give you a lot of classics, public domain ebooks, and what's so nice about it is that you can add notes and highlight, bookmark, and it also give you dictionary support. So this is an ideal for high school students. The reason for it is a lot of time, or high school students or a teacher, a lot of time is that you can, as a librarian, teachers come to you for recommendations. What's so good about it is that you can recommend this app to your teacher and where they can select books or title for their students on a class assignment basis. So you can because all these books are public domain books and classics, wouldn't it be nice to have a book club discussions or a reading contest or something where the materials or the books are available and free for download. And so this is a really good application to recommend to school teachers or students or even for people who are interested in holding book clubs or reading programs. So I just want to get a sense of, do you like it so far, or you know, all the apps that I featured? Give me a applause or a check, or I just want to see what are you guys, you know, what do you guys think of so far? Okay, good. I still have a lot to go, so a lot more apps. So if you're doing outreach, this is a must-have app for doing outreach. Basically, this is a Wi-Fi finder. For those of you who have worked in a bookmobile, you know how much of a challenge it is for you to connect to the Wi-Fi connection, or maybe your library patron. So this is a really great tool for you to have or bring it with you when you're doing outreach. This app allows you to find free Wi-Fi internet connections, hotspots, everywhere you go. And you can do that. You can do this offline, and this is just a wonderful tool for you to get access or find an internet access. Google Translate. I think most of you are familiar with this, but I just want to highlight that there is a new feature that the new version of Google Translate allows you to not only translate text and speech between about 70 languages, but it also allows you to now, with the new updated app, I encourage you to download a newer update or version of Google Translate. Basically, it allows you to use your phone or mobile device to place over a foreign text, a foreign language text, and it automatically translates the text into the language that you want. So for example, if you're traveling outside, you know, a foreign country, or if you see a sign, a non-English sign or a word or phrase, simply place your phone or take a picture of that text and it'll automatically convert or translate in back into English. So this has a lot of implication or application for library use. So for example, if you in your library you have Chinese materials or any non-English material and the patients come to you and ask you a question about this particular book, what is it about? So you can use this app or this or your mobile device, take a picture or place your phone over the text, and then it automatically or instantly convert the text into English. And this is a really good tool because when I'm at the reference desk, people always come to me for a non-English related titles, and they would sometimes bring a book or a magazine to see if we have a newer edition of that. And because I don't read certain languages, so I use this phone to translate. Another good use for that is that a lot of time when you're at the service desk and you have non-English speaker come to you and they want to ask very simple questions, and I use this app as a translator. So basically I hold up my phone and I say, "Hi, how can I help you?" in English, and then I would switch back to whatever language I think the person or the patron is speaking, and then I ask them to speak into my phone, and automatically Google will translate to me whatever they're saying. I mean, I know it's not an exact translation, but it at least helped me to get a sense of what they're asking for. So this is a really good app, and encourage every one of you to download this app because it really, especially if you're at the public service desk. So, IMDb Movie, I'm sure many of you are familiar with this app or the website. Basically, it has over 2 million plus movie and TV title. It allows you to search for actor, actress, directors. It also give you reviews, local TV listing, movie show times, give you also notification, alert of new titles and so forth. What I like about this app is that it allows you to navigate between the actors and the film directors, and also a lot of time when people come in and they just vaguely remember, oh yeah, there was a movie made, you know, whatever, and then I just can't remember the name. I want to watch that movie again. And they give you pieces of information about actor or the plot and so forth. This would be the best resource or tool to use to search that kind of information. So if you're working at desk, this would be a must-have. It sort of replaces your film encyclopedic materials on the shelf. So this is a great tool. My Congress is another app that that I frequently use, especially for the younger kids or who are just doing research on their lawmakers or congressmen or representatives. So basically, this app gives you facts about your local or national lawmakers, and it gives you the latest bill and law. It allows you to find your representative and see how they voted, and also be notified of any new changes of the law. And it also keeps you up to date as to what's going on in Washington or your state. And what I particularly like about this app is because you can find your Congress members by zip code. And a lot of times these Congress member changes every once in a while, and it's very hard for us and also for your patrons to keep up with it. So this app gives you the latest information about the Congress, the members, and then also give you, so this app gives you is almost replaced or comparable to the Statesman yearbooks that we have on the reference shelf. But this is a portable one, and you can take it with you. And this is a really good for outreach, and also for people who are just, you know, curious about what's going on in Washington and so forth, or at your state level. Another app is called NOLA Plain English Law Dictionary. This gives you over 4,000 legal terms and includes subject categories for each of the terms. And I like about it because once you download this app, you can work offline and you can have access to some of the general legal terms. So this app sort of replaces all the law dictionary that you have on a shelf. And it's, again, it's free, and you can use it. I mean, a lot of time people come in and they ask me about certain legal terms, which I have no ideas, but I rely on the app and as well as all the reference resources that we have in the back. So hopefully, and then a lot of time people are thrilled because now they have almost like a law library on their in their mobile device. Sit or Squat. I don't know if you heard of this app. This is a really funny app because it gives you a map of all the bathrooms. And it's color-coded and just to let you know whether the facility is open or not. Red meaning no, closed, and then green meaning, you know, open. And this is a really good app for if you're doing outreach, and then you can take this app with you just in case if anyone asks you where's the bathroom or so forth. And you can filter this by whether you can filter this to find out whether the bathroom is open or whether it's handicap accessible, whether if a mother has a baby, they want to have a changing table or maybe a family bathroom, you can do all that searches, and you can search by a location or by address as well. So I don't know whether it's international, but I think it's mostly in the U.S. So Health Hotline is another app published by the National Library of Medicine. This is a really good reference tool for health-related information or organizations. It basically allows you to find health-related organization in your local area as well as their toll-free phone number. It is a database of the National Library of Medicine directory of information resource online, and it contains 9,000 plus resources in the area of AIDS, cancer, aging, substance abuse, disability, and mental health. So these are just a few general category of that, but do check it out and download this app because this is a very useful in case if you're doing outreach or if you're even on the desk helping out patrons who have a health-related or information and they need a phone number or contact information. This would be a great app, and it also you can filter or you can search by state, by subject area, or by organization. And for those of you, for patrons who don't have a internet access or don't have a cell phone, they can also give you telephone number or hotlines to call these organizations. Job Search is another great app for people of any age, because if you're doing outreach, obviously for me, when I go out and do outreach to teens, most of them, you know, are interested in learning about, you know, job search or getting a job, and most of the time, people come to the library and they want information on, you know, not necessary for job search, but, you know, like books on how to write your resume, how to write a cover letter, and this would be a really good opportunity for us as a librarians or anybody, a lot of staff, to really push out the different tools that we have in the library in terms of job search, and this would be one of the tools. It gives you it's a very comprehensive app for providing job search. It gives you access to millions of job listings and allows you to save and email the job listing to whoever on your email. So really good tool for high school students and college students. So Khan's Academy is another great app which allows you to learn almost everything for free in any subject area. It allows you to get access a complete library over approximately 3,500 videos, and is good for students, and especially for those students who want last minute help in studying. I don't know whether you encounter this, because when I work at the desk, I often time people would come in last minute, students, and especially maybe moms or parents would come in the last minute before closing time and asking for materials for their kids or for their high school or middle school kids. So this would be a really good app for you to recommend to them in case or to any student if they're doing last minute work or if they want to get information, because they need to turn in their term paper by tomorrow, and now it's only 5:30 in the afternoon, and they want to get everything. So this would be a good app for them to just get an overview of their subject area that they're trying to learn. Lawyer.com. This is another app for you to search, or if you have encountered any question about finding a lawyer. So I don't know whether your library have people come in and you want to sue people, this would be a good app if you are encountering that type of questions. So you can search the attorney by name, practice area, and locations. It also give you ratings, give you profile of the law firms, and also give you contact information as well as directions. And what I like about this app is it's very easy and simple to use, and a clean interface, and basically just type in the attorney's or name or the practice area, and you get a list of attorneys, and is very useful tool for legal reference and for any kind of legal information. So good app. Mango Languages. I'm sure many of the library have subscribed to this service, Mango Languages. This app gives you, nevertheless, this is a really good app for outreach, because people are amazed, what you have to show them, because it just allows people to studies or learn foreign language courses, and it's totally free if your library subscribe to it. And what I like about this app is that you can record and play back, and just as having a real tutor. So when I'm doing outreach, especially to the teen populations or even the young adult populations, I usually recommend this app, because it's really cool, because once they download this app, they can learn any language. And a lot of time, many of the kids try to impress their friends, and they would speak different languages like French, Italians, and so forth. So this is a way for us as a librarian to somehow to get or spark their interest in other courses, language courses, as well as the library, and showing them that we have a lot of tools and resources for them, and it's just with a touch of a button, they can download all these cool apps and tools. Urban Dictionary, and this is a really good app, particularly if you're doing outreach. And then I use this app sort of to start conversations with other kids or teens, because this is a really cool app, because a lot of time this has all the terms and slangs and so forth, and it also allows you to do auto-complete suggestions in your search. And this is one of the more popular apps, and teens would get a kick of it once they, you know, get a see this, and they can search whatever they want. So do you guys like it so far? Give me a show of hands or applause if you like so far, because I think I have a lot more. All right. So, I encourage you to, if you, while I'm doing my presentation, encourage you to share your thoughts as well as the similar apps that you think your colleague may benefit. WebMD is another free app. It's a good source of information for quick medical health information. It includes symptoms, checkers, and treatments and conditions. And what I like about this app is that a lot of time it gives you, once you enter or your zip code, it allows you to find local doctors and hospital. And it's very comparable to your physician desk reference menu and the pill books and the first aid book. A lot of time I would carry this, or I would download this app and take it with me when I'm doing outreach, just in case if someone gets injured or if I have any questions about any medical or health information, or so I can use this app to give them a general information, you know, health information, or at least maybe sometime I get information about local hospital or doctors and so forth. This would be a handy app to carry with you when you're doing, or have with you when you're doing outreach. Another app, this is not a free app, unfortunately. It's 99 cents, but it's called World Factbook 2013. And it includes categories such as background of the country, geography, the people, government, economy, energy, communication, and all these good stuff about world facts. So this is a must-have app if you're doing any reference on a geography or country. So what I like about it is that this particular apps work offline. The map, you can search the map as well. And this is a really good tool for especially middle school students or even elementary school students. When they come in, they usually need to do maybe a book report on a country, and they want to find out just very general information about the flag or the people, or the geography, or the government, and so forth. This would be a really good app for that. This is one of the two that you should have when you're doing outreach, or if you're on a bookmobile and doing your outreach. And what if you need to print something up? This would be an app for you because it allows you to print from an iPad, or I'm not sure, I think it's only for iPad, but there are other printer apps available which you can print from an Android device. So in this case, this particular app is for iPad. So basically allows you to print from an iPad to a Wi-Fi printer and support Microsoft Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and all the key applications. For example, you know, also PDF, HTML, and picture, JPEG as well. And I must say this is a must-have tool or app for any kind of reference work or an outreach if you're doing that. Okay, sports lover. A lot of time people come and ask me for, you know, like, what's going on? You know, what's the latest score of the local team? So I would use this app for getting the latest score or team information on different sports. You'd be amazed how comprehensive of all the different types of sports, major sports listings or informations. Also, you can skip set your scoreboard highlight alert. Let's say you say, oh, let me know if you're working. I'm not encouraging that, but let's say if you're working on a desk, and you're working on the desk, and then you want to keep up with what's going on in your team, and then you can set the alert, and what happened if someone's a score or someone, you know, reaches a certain score, it'll send you a text alert. So therefore, you can be working and watching or monitoring your team doing. So great app. This is also has a lot of information for your patron, the library user, and I totally recommend this app because it's a very comprehensive, very easy to use, and you can search almost everything about your local teams as well. Global Business Law. This is published by Thomson Reuter Business. It provides over 47 multi-jurisdictional practice area. And basically, the basic version is free, but you can add on or buy content as you go. You get the most reliable business news or information worldwide. And you get contact information of the local legal expert as well. So it also provides you a link to a dictionary of different terms. So this is a really good app if you're a business librarian and if you have patrons or library users who come in and ask you about business law and so forth, then you may want to recommend this app for them because it is very comprehensive. It provides, you know, a lot of practice area and spread over different area and worldwide. Okay, clinical trial mobile. This gives you clinical trial. It's a basic information, and it also is a database of National Library of Medicine. It gives you all the information about clinical trial, and you can search, save studies, and also you can enroll in different studies. And what I like about it is a very comprehensive database of clinical trial information and is worldwide and is very easy to use, and you can easily find a study as well. I know I'm running a little bit out of time, but I try to do as much I can to make it really fast. So Find a Health Center is another free app for finding or looking for a federally funded health center, and you can type in the zip code and it'll give you your local federally funded health center. These are maybe like free health care centers. What I like about it is very easy to use. It's really good for outreach, especially if you're going to a low-income family populations or people who have no insurance and they want to get immunizations or checkups for their children. So this is a really good app to have or take with you if you're serving a low-income populations or families. LibriVox audiobooks give you access to over 10,000 plus free audiobook, and include world literature, novels, history, biography, short story, and so on. And you can search by titles, authors, and genre. I like this app because it's very easy to use and stream, and is an alternative platform, a way to get digital content, especially audiobooks. And this has a really good application, library application, because I use it to help or to get a reluctant user, a reluctant reader to read, start reading. And this is a really good tool for you if you're doing a book club. You can send a link to your book club member and ask them to listen to this book or maybe to get a copy of the book, and then you can come back maybe in a month or so a later time and discuss the book. And again, this is a really good app for you to do outreach and to reach out to those reluctant readers. And I think I have a few more apps, so just bear with me. This is a really good app. This is called Leaf Snap. It gives you images of leaf, flower, fruits, and seeds, and everything in your local area. Basically, it is a field guide by Columbia University of Maryland and Smithsonian Institute. And basically, you can search by different plant families. And what's so cool about it is once you type in your zip code, you can find, or your location, you can find all the different plants. It'll give you a picture of the different plant in that, in your locations. So it is a very good for people who are interested in plant science and people who want to just, you know, find out what different things in the local area. So another good app is called Health Path. This will get you quick tips from a medical doctor. This app allows you to interact or text your a certified doctor. And the doctors are volunteer their time, and they give free medical tips and advice. And a lot of time, you know, when we work at the reference desk, people come to us and they want some kind of medical information, and I'm sort of hesitant to give that information. So sometimes we recommend people to use this app, and they can just text their talk to any of the doctors, and then you get tips on different symptoms, conditions, medical conditions, and health concerns. And what I like about this app is you get access, instant access to medical information, and it's a really good tool for outreach for low-income families, teens, and adults, especially for teens if they have some sort of, if they have embarrassing questions or medical health questions they want to ask, but they are so hesitated to ask you. So this would be an app, this would be a tool for them to perhaps to chat with a professional. World Newspaper is another app that I frequently use to or recommend to patrons. Is you can basically read newspapers, a publication worldwide, and you can browse by country, subject area, and publications, and you can add different channel and get feed. And I like about it is because it allows you to save and read offline the content, and also if it also translates for you into English. So if you happen to, let's say, stumble upon certain country and you want to get the latest local news abroad, then you can, or maybe you don't or you don't read the foreign, the language, you can get it translated back in English. Really good app. Totally recommend. Health, diet, and grocery food scanner. This allows you to manage your health conditions. And also, this app developed by a group of registered dietitians, and basically allows you to scan the food, the back of your, you know, bark, the canned food, whatever label, the scanner, in the back of the food packaging, and let you find out whether or not it is a good match for your diet. So basically, you tell them, you tell or you enter your medical conditions or health conditions, and this app will tell you whether, they'll give you a score, whether you should eat this particular type of food or not. Really good app. I think this is the last apps. STD treatment guide. This is a really good app for to get quick STD treatments, and you can browse by condition. Basically, it dispels the myths with the facts, and what I like about it, it's very comprehensive guide, and is really good for outreach for young adult and teens, especially if they have like questions about STD and if they're embarrassed about to ask you. So this would be a really good tool for doing outreach. And the last app I think I have is YP. It gives you over 18 million local businesses and events, and is you can search by category, popular category. And what I like about this app is particularly you can find local events or current events. A lot of time you're doing outreach and people come to you and they want to find out what's going on in this area, you know, like meaning like what is showing on this theaters, or is there any lecture talks, or is there any book club in this area? Tell me more about, and then this app will tell you once you enter your location, or you can turn on your GPS, and then it'll tell you, it'll give you all the listings, what's going on, or even in locally. So as a librarian, this is a great tool because we don't know anything going on in not many of us know anything in our local area, but this will provide you the tools and the resource and the information. And it's comparable to what we used to have, a find it binders on our shelf and or telephone books and also Reference USA. So this app sort of very comparable or replace all the information that. So if you want to get more information or if you want more apps, Tom Duffy and I did a presentation over at the Internet Librarian this year, and we have 50 apps features. If you want to get more information or download our presentation or watch our presentations online, you can go to this web page here, and then I have handout over on the website, and then you can download that as well. So let's see. Any questions? So I'm going to open up for questions. Any comments, or if I still have time to do that.
Thank you, Richard.
Oh, you're welcome. So here's my contact information if you want to contact me or follow me at Twitter. I just tweeted a few links or apps that you guys can take a look at.